You're tuned in to the afterparty.com.
You are tuned in to the B-side on thaafterparty.com.
Hey y'all, this is Stuckey from the podcast 2 BBCs. That's 2 Broke Black Chicks. We're live every Friday from 7 to 8 p.m. talking about sex, being broke, and living in the city of Dallas. Be sure to tune in every Friday on Side B on the After Party Radio. See you at the party.
I didn't even know he told us we was live.
He didn't. He just gave us a head nod over there being drunk and shit.
Look, he like, shut up, y'all.
What's good? I missed y'all.
This is episode 33, and we are 2 BBCs, two broke black chicks. We come with y'all with another episode. We miss y'all. Like she said, we miss y'all so much. These weeks be going by so slow, but so fast at the same time, child.
Right.
So we're going to get straight into it. How was y'all week this week?
My week was good. My week was real good. I worked a lot. I worked a lot. Did a lot of promo for the party coming up. Speaking of, I got some flyers that I meant to drop off here. You need a ticket? I got you. I definitely got you. Did you tell my girlfriend I said hey though? Okay, I didn't think so. Yeah, I had a really good week. It was really sexually uneventful. Didn't get no dick. Let's see. I did shoot at a girl, though.
How did that go?
I know.
It went pretty good. We supposed to be meeting up. So.
How you shoot at her?
I mean, I just told her, I was like, what's up? Are you into girls or not? Like, I need to know, like, because you sexy as shit. And she she's not chocolate, but she dark brown, pretty skin. She just might be a little dinky.
No!
But I'm cool with that. I'm definitely cool with that because I like them young, dumb, and full of cum. You know what I'm saying? So,
I'm sick of you.
I got super fucking drunk last night on accident, y'all.
I seen. Like, I was like, that bitch gonna be drunk.
I was accidentally drunk. We had a meeting, and at the meeting, I went ahead and got everybody. I don't know why I thought I was balling. I got everybody around the Patron. And then I got me 2 rounds of Crown Apple. We hit the parking lot. I had like two or three big chugs of Jameson. We went to the bar and had green tea shots. Then I went to Townhouse. It was drinking for free at Townhouse, drinking Hennessy for free and champagne and Hennessy at Townhouse. So I was lit, and I didn't know I was lit until I woke up this morning and discovered that I had went to the food truck, and I thought I was going to have some food to eat in the morning. I literally had 1 piece of meat and 2 vegetables on that skewer left, and I bought 2, and I don't remember eating none of them hoes, but I got in my car this morning, and it looked like I threw up skew you everywhere. And it wasn't, I didn't throw up.
So you
I was just
all?
Eating hard than a bitch. I mean, food flying everywhere. So,
when I think that I have more leftovers than I really actually have.
Man, like, say. I put my shit in the refrigerator like, okay, it's going to be good. I'm going to keep it in there for a few minutes. I slept with it in my bed. I think I ate it in my sleep because when I woke up, I had a mouthful of food.
Oh, my gosh.
That shit was tragic.
That's
I'm trying
crazy.
To get our Instagram live to work. Stuckey, how was your week?
It was good. When I left here Friday, I had sex with this light-skinned boy. Usually we have sex, but it's really, really not. We just fucking with each other just to be fucking with each other.
It's nothing.
I don't think that he like me. I don't like him. It was a situation where I know him for like a long time, and I thought that it was more than what it was. I mean, I thought that we connected more than what it was. We really just be like hooking up and having sex. The sex be good, but it's like not a, I really want to be with him and he really want to be with me. We just in the same spot right now where we don't want to meet other people and have sex with them. And we know that we both clean. So, and I got wet pussy and he got a big dick. So why not? Or whatever. So last time I had sex with him, I was like, oh, okay, let me just go over here. And he really, like, was real passionate. Like, I was like, oh, my God, I think I can. Because at first, I was just going to head sick to him that one time and then stop, like, hitting him up. Like, not even hitting him up. He hit me up. Stop, like, going over there. And then he really, like, fucked me. Like, he was, like, my boyfriend or, like, my husband, child. And it was really, 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 really good. He bent me. Yes, honey. He bent me over the sink. And he was hitting it from the back. We was hitting, like, we was, like, fucking on his couch, fucking on his bed, fucking around all his house that he do have. And I didn't know that he lived on his own in a 3-bedroom house, child. I thought that, I think his parents died. I don't know, child.
Oh, okay.
For real, because his parents was, like, old while we was, like, younger. And they not there no more. And I know they didn't move out that house. I know one of them had. I know
they
that.
Might be on, like, traveling shit.
No, I think his daddy or his mama died.
Why did somebody kick the bucket and shit?
Like, I don't ask people business, but it was really, 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 really good. Like, it was really good.
I can't really speak on that because my friend has a dude or whatever, and his parents leave simultaneously for months. You know what I'm saying? To take care of their parents and stuff like that. So, that's why I be like, well, maybe they not dead. Maybe they just travel or they doing their own thing, but...
I'm pretty sure they probably did because his mama was old. I think his mama was like 60 10 years ago. So, no, I'm serious.
Damn.
I'm serious. I think his mama was like 60 10 years ago. He got old parents like DC Young Fly. So, yeah.
I understand
But it was real good. Then I got a raise, and we rumored to have another raise overall. So, I need to make $2 more an hour than I'm making right now so I can really just have extra money, I guess. But I got a raise or whatever, so I'm happy about that. And then I'm telling you, it's rumored that our company is going to have another raise. Hopefully that lady didn't lie, and hopefully she's not a habitual liar, like, or hopefully the rumor is true, but yeah, our position is going to be starting higher, so they already have to get, so if they make it $2 higher, they'll give us $2 on what we already making.
Yeah. That's good.
So, I'm super, 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 super happy, because I'm going to be able to actually make as much money as I really want to make, and actually have, like, an extra $1,000 to actually have with my paychecks. If this is true. If it's not, I have an extra probably like $700, which is still
that's
good. Lit.
That's still good.
But yeah, I want an extra $1,000. I'm trying to at least make like $5,000 a month.
That's not nothing wrong with it.
Like, I'm trying to make $5,000 a month. I know ain't nothing wrong with it. I'm saying people don't understand that. I'm trying to make $5,000 a fucking month so I can be comfortable, pay all my bills with one half of that $1,000, and then have another $1,000 just to splurge for the next 2 weeks. Or, you know, $1,500 or $1,300. So that's really my goal, is to make $5,000 a month. Any way that I can, and I think I'm going to probably do another job, but I don't know. Because working two jobs, that ain't something that you just do. That's something you got to mentally prepare yourself to do.
And you got to know what you're working for. And I've done it for years.
Because I did. I had three jobs at one time.
You remember, I had two jobs when I had to buy my car. I had to buy my first car by myself. And I had to work two jobs, two minimum wage jobs to buy my car. So... that ain't something that you just, okay, I'm going to just pick up a, no, that's something you got to be motivated, but I don't know. Hopefully this raise push me over the top so I can be making my goal month to month, you know,
in
salary.
In 6 months, I'm supposed to double in my pay, and my hourly pay, because they're going to switch me from a clerk to a counselor. But y'all, when I say I really like the front desk, and
you like talking to people.
I fucking love it. Like, talking to them people, they be some interesting ass people, and they have some stories to tell, bitch. They be living some harsh ass life. So
what?
I like that shit.
Oh gosh.
But yeah, I wanted to do that at Parkland. They will not hire me, like, at all. I filled out a whole bunch of applications at Parkland. They was like,
do you know how many applications,
bro,
I filled out at Parkland before I actually got a job?
How many?
Maybe a close to 30.
Yeah, I had
no,
I
like,
filled out.
No lie, no bullshit, no
yeah,
exaggeration.
I filled
it was
out
like
over 200 applications around the DFW area. Like, when I moved back, everybody had their fucking job. Everybody was set, and I was the only one that's looking like, I don't have my job. I filled out over 200 applications. My mom did not believe me, and I was like, look at these emails. Like, in 30 minutes, they'll be like, no. So I'm glad that I do not miss looking for a job in Dallas.
The only reason why I got my job is because my mama worked there. Period, point blank.
Yeah, and I was trying to get put on in my mama company. She couldn't put me on. I was like, damn, I have to really, like, get it from the mud with these fucking jobs, bro. You remember, I kept going to these temporary things.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, my God, I have to work with this person. I have to work with that person.
Girl, that's the funniest story is with you working with that crackhead. And nobody was having really withdrawals.
Nobody will really believe me because it's so outrageous. But I really had to, girl, I had to work at Teleperformance 3 times on some temporary bullshit, bro. Like, I would never... That's why I like the job that I have now. Everybody can't get that job. Like, you ain't going to be working with everybody. So, that's what I really, 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 really like about the job that I have now. Because it's like, you have to really pass a series of tests to really go through them motherfucking tests. Because I done worked with everybody. I done worked at a call center where it was a fight. Somebody was about to shoot up the call center. Like, I done worked at a whole bunch. I worked at
Even
warehouse.
Even though I said, fuck State Farm, I really, really miss that job. I really do. That was a really good job with really good benefits. It was just my boss, Becky the Bucktooth Bandit. I hated that bitch.
Bro, that's how I was at that hospital. I loved that job that I worked at that hospital. It was not easy for me to quit that mug. Every paycheck, you got seven hours of PTO, my nigga. Yeah. Every fucking paycheck. And then they pay for your school. Yeah, they changed the rules where they pay for your school regardless if it's like medical or not. So they'll pay for your school and they'll give you the money up front and pay for it. And then what else? They had really, 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 really good benefits. It's just that I couldn't move my position that I wanted to go into. And then the management was horrible. I hate the management.
Landon, I need you. Can you come here?
He's so sick of my shit, y'all.
Can you hand me my phone? Thank you. Sorry. It's just not working. But yeah, I mean, how was your week, Toola?
My week was good. I work a lot. My work been kicking my ass for really, to be honest with you, for like 3 weeks now. It's been like 3 weeks. It's going to be a month now. Over the weekend, I don't think I did anything at all. Oh, I dropped out for my fucking tires.
Okay. That I had to You do got on. All four?
Yes. Fucking, I'm not mad about it because I needed it, but I didn't want to fucking do it, but I did it anyway. Oh, God. So that's all I did. And what else I do? I did something on Thursday. Oh, I had fun on Thursday for like 15 minutes.
What did you do?
Mind your business, bitch.
Okay.
Not even 15 minutes. It was more like 5.
Okay. A high five. Ain't nothing wrong with it, bitch. I've been trying to get dick all week, and my booty buddy has been denying me. So, fuck it. I'm trying to find. I told y'all I was trying to find some new dick. And
yeah. Oh, I got a, like a. I just thought of something. Have y'all ever like sucked dick and then swallowed it? And then you was hungry? Like you been starving like maybe 20 minutes later?
Like Chinese food?
Yes, like you didn't like you just didn't have a stomach full of food. I think the sperm ate up all my food.
Yeah, that's definitely. I've definitely had that feeling before where I got filled up and then I was hungry as shit. Like, ooh, time to eat. But it's always time to eat after sex for me. A bitch be needing a snack.
What?
A snack.
I need
snack.
A whole meal.
Yeah. So y'all. I asked this question on Instagram the other day, and I want to know what y'all think about it. How long should one sex session last?
I am okay with you giving me 20 to 30 minutes. I'm okay with that. Like, I don't like this to be fucked for no hour. Like, no, I'm sorry. That's not going to work for me. Okay. Like, don't fuck me for no hour. Like, I think I'm okay with 20 to 30 minutes. And 30 minutes is pushing it because it's going to make me question my pussy, to be very honest with you. 30 minutes? Bitch, what? Really? 15. A good hot 15
yeah.
is great.
About 17, 18 minutes. That's some good sex.
But if you got to push it, go ahead and hit me to a 30. 30 is okay, but if it's gone after 30, I'm going to think something wrong with you. I'm going to think that you done popped a Cialis or a Viagra
or my pussy is not as good as I thought it was, but that has never happened to me. Oh, except when I was fucking this one nigga and he was on perks.
Yeah, them perkies.
Yeah,
and I thought they were. I thought they were actually downers.
Not I mean, a dick.
Yeah, they downers, but they uppers. Like they keep your dick up, but you'll pass the fuck out.
Yes,
while getting like, some pussy. Like, come on now.
Yes, my shit was swole. Like, I was over it. Don't ever fuck a nigga on perks, y'all. I mean, it's great.
It's good.
But it's like, goddamn. When is this going to end? Like, your dick is not getting soft, and I'm not making you nut. Like, bitch, we going to die up in this bitch. Like, mm-mm.
Yeah.
So, how long do you think, Stuckey?
20 minutes.
20? A hot 20? Mm-hmm. If you're getting a good hot 20, how many rounds do you want?
One round of 20 minutes.
Okay.
20 minutes.
Cause I like to go rounds. I'm not gonna lie.
I like to go rounds too.
But you know that
rounds.
First round, it usually be like quick.
Mm-hmm.
Well, for me, it's usually like quick, and then that second round, that's when you get like a good 20 minutes in. So I'm good for like 2-3 rounds. Now 3-4, you're not fucking me for 3-4 rounds. Now maybe I can suck your dick, but bitch, you're not fucking me for 3-4 rounds. Like, I'm so sorry.
See,
I can go 3-4 rounds with, like, a nigga that I really like. Or if we laid up for the whole day. Like, that's how I used to.
Oh, if it's for the whole day, that makes sense. Mm-hmm. For the whole day. I'm thinking, like, within, like, the time frame of a nighttime.
I can't do that.
Yeah.
I can do time.
Now, if we laid in the bed all day, or we ain't got shit to do, or we're on vacation or something.
I'm going to drain you.
I'm going drain your motherfucking ass. But lately, I've been having fucking marathon sex.
What does that mean?
That shit lasts rounds. I mean, not even rounds, but for a very long time. Me and old dude, the love of my life.
The one I don't like.
The one you don't like. So.
There you go, putting it. She wasn't even going
to
say it.
Yeah, I wasn't going to say it this time. I was going
to
say it.
I want the listeners to know this is the same dude, since that's what you refer to him as. You got to keep the people,
the one that Toola does not like. But, yeah, for some reason, he has been fucking the dog shit out of me for hours. Like, for hours. We literally fucked so long in the shower, the water got cold in apartments. Do you know how long it takes for the water to get cold in the apartment?
A very long time. Like, you know, a very long time. Because a very long time.
But I did get mad at him the other night because we usually shower together. And every time we shower together, we end up fucking in the shower. And he's a very tall nigga. So
I like him tall.
I don't mind bending over in the shower and getting fucked by him because he gonna block all the water from my hair getting wet and shit. So
that's the great thing.
But I don't know. Oh, I had went to Rudy's. I had picked us up some Rudy's. And he got in the shower first. And I was still eating. So, I ate. He was in the shower. I got out the shower. He ate. I was rubbing his back. You know, hugging on him, kissing on him. I got in the shower. When I got out in the shower, that nigga was knocked the fuck out.
He was tired.
I mean, knocked the fuck out. Like, I was playing with his dick, his balls. I was kissing him. He was like, move, I'm asleep. And I was hurt.
I would be hurt, too. Nigga, like, don't tell me to fucking move and you sleep. All them times I've been fucking sleep and you slip your dick in my goddamn pussy.
You know what I'm saying?
Like, no.
You didn't put these panties to the side. So, I mean, well, I don't really sleep in panties when
I don't sleep naked, so
I don't
go to sleep the first. I don't never go to sleep. Like, I'm always up at a nigga house, like, nigga, like. So I can go rounds. I don't know. I can just go rounds. I be really liking the people I have sex. I don't know. Because if I'm spending night over there, 9 times out of 10, you're not just somebody I'm just having sex with just randomly.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, just like the nigga that I'm fucking right now. Like I said, we ain't had no deep connection. I would have been done spent the night over his house. He have a 3-bedroom house. Like, but I don't, now I'll probably be spending the night over there, but I can go around.
See how y'all go. My vagina be woe the fuck.
That's because you like humongrow dicks, bro.
Yeah, my vagina be woe out after, it's really roe out after three.
Some niggas didn't wore my ass out and say, listen, that shit ain't nowhere near fun, you hear me?
Yes, it's not even like your body be woe out, it's just that your, you know your vagina needs to become unswole.
Yeah.
Or some shit. Like, she needs more than just a few minutes to recuperate. And pushing that nigga out. Yeah. That has happened to me multiple times. I'm like, I just can't. Like,
I'm sorry.
She
like,
she doesn't want you in there.
It's not, I don't want to fuck. It's my coochie. Yeah. I can't go no more. It's done. She's out of there.
I hate when that happens.
Me too, because I be wanting to show out sometimes.
I know, you got to sing that song. Like, yeah, bitch. Pussy don't fail me now.
Okay.
I know, right?
I got to turn his brother out, because he don't want nobody else.
Don't bitch, really. I've been singing that song all weekend.
Bitch, I be having talks with my Penelope. Be like, bitch, don't you come that fast this time, bitch. You better make it. And don't tap out.
No, but for real, you really have to talk.
She does her own thing.
Yeah, my coochie does her own thing.
Like, sometimes totally she want to be, you know what I'm saying? Like,
sometimes she can go for round, and then sometimes she'll get one or two nuts and be like, yeah, you done. You done. Oof. You swole.
And I'm taking it out of here.
Go sit your ass down. Because we not having fun no more.
Yeah.
It hurt.
But that's weird like when a 20-30 minutes, is that's great for me. I don't like that Mr. 60 minutes, I'm going to fuck you for an hour type shit, because, nah. And then, you know me, I don't like to sweat.
You got to like, keep it exciting if we fucking for an hour, bro.
Like, what the hell we going to be doing for an hour? An hour is a long-ass time to have sex, y'all.
But we can switch positions, because I usually get my breath when I switch positions. You know what I'm saying? When I'm getting on top, because I'm not riding dick for more than 7-8 minutes at a time in the session. Because my legs are not that strong.
Wait, you can ride it for 7-8 minutes?
I can ride 7-8 minutes.
Baby, you great.
Yeah, that's good. I feel like I can ride dick until a nigga nuts. So I feel like that's pretty good for me.
That's really good. Like, give me high five, girl.
Girl,
baby. I like the way that this ass is set up in my back, bitch, new.
Girl, that's what people understand. If you have like a big butt, your butt is heavy nine times out of ten. Like, people don't understand that. That's why I put on my Facebook. I'm like, niggas don't even be knowing what to do with a big ass. All they do is just tell you to spread your fucking cheeks.
Yes, because you get a paper cut.
So they be trying to tell you to spread your fucking cheeks the whole motherfucking time.
And that shit is not. Now, what's up? My ass is heavy. I kid you not. I think my ass is 50 pounds of my fucking weight.
I mean, shit. I like riding dick. I do it froggy style and doggy style. So, reverse cowgirl. On my knees, fucking. I like it. I like it all. I like riding dick. I really, 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 really like riding dick.
That's great. You're going to have to give me some lessons.
Bitch, do squats. That's all I can tell you.
That's what I've been doing.
Or you will catch a trolley horse. I have caught a trolley horse while having sex and had to fight my way through that shit.
Riding dick is if you don't do it, you gonna lose it, bitch. Cause I lost
for
it.
Real.
Like I
do
lost
you ride,
it.
Or who? How are you trying to ride dick?
I wanna do it on my tippy toes. I wanna do it on my knees. I wanna do it multiple ways, like, huh? But it's just that I actually have to do it like multiple times a week for me to get back in the groove of it. But
girl, cause I had to send my friend Jakira a video. Of me riding dick on my knees, because she was like, I'm not riding dick on my feet, bro. I said, bro, you can still be real sexy. You can still make a nigga come on your motherfucking knees. You do not have
and
to
it's not as
be on your feet.
You being on your feet and squatting.
Yes. And then
your knees shit gives you a little bit of leeway.
And then some people, they be wanting the dick to be all the way in your pussy. And certain people, when they do it on their feet, dick don't be in there.
Oh, come on. I twerk when I ride dick.
Yeah.
So I be doing the tip. Right on that tip, I be...
Then you got to figure out what type of dick your nigga got. Because some niggas, they don't have the ride on your feet type dick.
Yeah.
If you know what I mean. Like, some of them, you have to ride on your knees or you're not going to... It's not going to work.
And then even certain people, like certain niggas that be like laying down... You have to, like, lay straight. You can't have your pelvic part in the bed most of the time. Like, you have to lay straight for me to get all up on there. Like, you can't have your pelvic part like that. You have to actually, like, be up a little bit for me for it
what
to actually go right.
What you mean by that is it can't be sunken in. You can't be sunked in because that's not... That's more work for
that's
us.
That is, like... Yeah.
Like, you have to have, like, what do you call those? A Tempur-Pedic?
Yes.
A mattress, a firm mattress.
Put a pillow
so you
up under
sink
you or something.
Under that shit.
Yeah. And that's why I always tell girls.
Do y'all niggas, do they legs be spread? Why?
Yeah, you have to pull them together.
So y'all put them together. Mm-hmm. Baby, my last nigga, his legs was just always spread. And mind you, y'all, he was like 6'8", 6'9". And I was like, you gotta put them hoes together.
Yeah, you need to put your feet together.
And he wasn't like small, but he wasn't big. But you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm thick. So he's like, my legs can open up pretty wide. But it was just really, really hard when his
legs. Oh, yeah, your thighs, your thighs, and your legs are two different things. I can get these legs pretty wide. I can almost do the splits, but these thighs.
My that shit petty. So motherfuckers real life be having their legs wide open. No, nigga, you have to put your legs together. Let me cuff these balls up before I put them together, but you have to put these bitches together. I'm not about to be working time and a half in this bitch while you just be like laying there. And then I always tell my followers all the time, like, bitch, you don't have to be in the bed riding dick. Ride dick on the couch. That's why all them porn stars be doing it.
Why that nigga is sitting up.
That's the easiest way.
Like, to ride dick is on the couch. You do not have to be in the bed, my nigga.
Do y'all want a demonstration? Let me show you.
Calm down.
I'm really horny, okay? Yeah. Like, it's been a while because my nigga is bipolar.
What you mean it's been a while? Didn't you have sex earlier this week? What's a while? Like, last weekend?
It was last weekend.
Bitch. That's not no wow. You need to, people is struggling out here. Some people ain't had sex in 7 months.
Okay, well, it was only a 8-minute shower session, so I need some fucking dick. I want to be fucked. And this one nigga keep hitting me up thinking he gonna fuck me, but I fucked him once, and he couldn't last. I had to play with my pussy to get a nut. You know what I'm saying? Like, I had to finish myself off because he couldn't get hard again. And I'm like, is it me? Look, I literally took my hand, put my hand in my coochie. I was like, nope, tight as a whistle. Let me smell it. Oh, nope, smells good as fuck. This nigga just can't last. He nutted already. He didn't want to tell me.
I hate when they do that. Because then, just tell us that you nutted, that you nut quick. Because then you're going to have us thinking like, damn. Like, what the fuck wrong with my goddamn pussy? Yeah. What the fuck did I do wrong? Like, what the fuck I did to turn him off when you really, like, low-key, I already nutted 5 minutes ago? But that's a... Oh, since you won't like big dick niggas will do that to you. Because they dick is so big, sometimes you don't know when they go soft. Because they dick is so big. Yeah. Like, that should be happening. That should... But it still feel good. Because the dick is...
I mean, it's still big. As long as it's still...
Yeah.
As long as I'm still being penetrated and I can feel it. Now, I've literally felt a nigga go south inside of me before.
Yeah, I have.
And that shit feels like
going
from a fucking, what do you call the summer sausage to a...
A weenie?
No, not even a weenie, because weenies ain't even a...
Kaneka sausage?
No, bitch. To a fucking gummy worm.
I've been saying, because them hoes,
they shrink and... They get soft and mushy.
Oh, that's the East Texas Hot Link. Have you had East Texas Hot Links?
Uh-uh.
Baby, them things is like this big and they soft and squishy. They was really good when I ate pork and beef. That's I used to eat those. Yeah, that's the East Texas Hot Link.
No, I don't want no fucking East Texas Hot Link inside my vajayjay. I'm going to be like, what the fuck, bro?
Yeah, I hate soft dicks. Like, I need my dicks to be hard. Like, it's rock fucking... Hard. Like I said, like you can cut cocaine with it.
Hey, baby. My boo just walked in the studio, y'all. We gotta have her as a guest.
Okay, with that. Gonna cut with
hey, baby.
Hey.
So, yeah, we was talking about how long sex should last.
She want a headset?
Huh?
Sure, as long as you please.
You want to get on the mic? Because I already told you I'm gonna have you on as a guest.
Okay.
So, the pink is fine. This designer pussy. This designer pussy.
Hey.
You know what I mean? she just stopped in real quick. She wasn't my guest for the evening. Because our hoe ass guest for the evening didn't show the fuck up.
Oh, no.
So, we gonna... I don't talk about her later in a later episode. But really, on the cool, I'm going to start charging y'all motherfuckers. Y'all got me fucked up. Shit ain't cool. It's like, I pay for this time. We pay for this time. We do this. It's a business. And y'all fucking with my money. So, yeah, huh?
I thought you started doing that shit from the last time.
Yeah, but this was prearranged. Remember how long ago?
Oh, yeah.
I said she was going to be on the show?
Yeah.
This was months in advance.
Yeah.
So.
You're right.
Bitch, you out of line. And then I answer the phone and I act like I, bitch, you see me calling you.
Yeah, now so you're acting like it's not. I'm sorry, my bad. I was about to co-sign all of that. You can't act like my shit ain't fly enough for you to pull up.
How long would y'all... How long do you say your sex session would last?
Come over this way.
I feel like it all varies. You know what I mean? I done had real good short sex. I had real good long sex. Mm-hmm. The longest sex I had was about 8 hours, and we was rolling.
Okay.
Wait, where the bell at?
It was about 8 hours. We was in Houston. We was rolling. And that, yeah, we just kept going.
Yeah. I remember one time having sex for so long, we was rolling. We actually fell out the bed, but we were still intertwined. His dick was still inside of me. So that's how we felt. We fell off a twin bed and was still fucking. So we were rolling so hard.
We started fucking on the freeway, like while he was driving.
See, I ain't never fucked.
My little ass is purple.
Now, I can suck a dick while the nigga is driving, but fucking him,
oh, yeah,
I'm scared.
Yeah, I'm scared we gonna crash.
We wasn't even worried about none of that. I mean, I guess now that would have been a safety hazard.
Yeah, I mean, but yeah, man, too. I'm guessing it will.
It happened. It happened.
Huh? Can we? We. Okay. Thank you. Fuck you, Landon. Sorry, guys. My engineer hates me. It's obvious. But, I know I get on your nerves. It's totally fine. You just want to fuck me. I understand.
Hold up. You know what?
You can only get on the person's nerves if you want to fuck them.
That tension.
Just admit it. I mean, like, that's the only reason why I rub you the wrong way, because you ain't rub me the right way. I get it.
Nigga, how did you get that bell?
Baby, I'm a fool with this goddamn bell.
Get to rubbing.
I mean,
why he hiding now? I can't see his face. He probably embarrassed. Don't be embarrassed.
Why his face don't change, though?
It don't. He got his face smirking every time.
Same smirk. Since you are here in the studio, Designer Pussy, and we're going to hit you with it.
Is that your nickname?
That's my brand. That's her brand. Oh, that's one of my brands. I'm a designer. I go by Yik Styles. That's the full name of the brand. Mm-hmm. And Designer Pussy is kind of just one of my lines, one of my collections.
Put that up in there, because I
love close. We rolling with it. Designer Pussy is a new bad bitch. You know, you have good pussy. We as women, I feel like, are downplayed a lot by everyone around us, whether it's other women, men, kids, whatever. Mm-hmm. And we just forget about how precious we really are. We have a whole womb. We birth. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. We create. We without us, ain't no world.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So, we got Designer Pussy. We have high, top-notch, luxurious pussy.
Yep.
And you need to know that as a woman. Can't nobody touch you? Can't anybody just touch you? You got Designer Pussy.
Yep, I agree with that.
Mm. So since you ain't a guest yet, I ain't gonna put you through
the ringer.
We finna speed round the shit out your ass.
Yes. Okay. I like your tattoo.
Thank you.
Fire. Mm-hmm. Okay. So, missionary or doggy?
Dog.
Spit or swallow?
Swallow.
Damn, can I get it out first?
I mean, you said speed.
But I wasn't finished with the question.
I know, right?
Choke the slap.
Both of them.
At the same time?
At the same time. Mm-hmm.
Yes, choke the slap at the same time.
At the same time.
Gotta love it. At the same damn time. On that future shit. Okay, what's another one?
I'm little, so I want all you gotta show me. I'm short, but I be standing like I'm 8 feet tall. So you gotta come with it. You know what I mean? Like, my personality too big for you to just be over here like trying to be gentle shit. Nah, we gonna get to it.
So mm-hmm. I was just gonna say rough or romantic?
I like rough more than romantic.
I like rough romantic.
Rough romantic.
Passionate.
You know, rough with the intimacy.
passionate.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, rough with the intimacy. Yeah. You know what I mean? Because it could still be very sexy.
Like, choke me and kiss me at the same time.
Yeah.
Nah, I'm like, bite my nipple. Bite my clit.
Wait over here.
No, wait a minute. Shit, because I don't know what it is about my... I don't know what it's been about my nipples lately. You know, I got nipple rings. I think it's the nigga I'm fucking with. He's so damn rough. When I say this nigga grabs my shit and tugs and pulls on like my nip. Yes, bitch, on my nipple rings. Like, that shit hurts.
Why would he do that?
I tell him. He's like, shut the fuck up.
Somebody, a nigga grabbed my chest and balled it in his fist before. I've never in my life. I said, why did you do that? He was like, I didn't do that. Yes, you did. I didn't know where my chest went. I was like, damn. It was in his fist. Like, the side wasn't poking out or nothing. What the fuck? I didn't know what to do.
Oh my god. Aside
of it wasn't poking out anywhere. It was just in his fist.
He was trying to ring.
I wish a nigga would.
I don't know.
Bitch, a nigga can't.
Well, I'll bet him dead in his shit.
We got two big of things. Like, yeah, I'm quick to fight. Sir. What is grip?
Yeah, I'm gonna fuck up the whole move, but I just want to tell y'all this meme that my friend sent me. It says, while your mom is somewhere praying for your safety, you're in some man's bed telling him to choke you. I said, bitch, if that wasn't me,
okay.
Because,
that's how my mom passed out, y'all.
And you're someone with your KKK.
With my KKK mask, bitch.
What you talking about?
Okay, so I was fucking with a nigga that works in factory warehouse type industries type thing. So he had this like white mesh kind of bag, and we made it into a mask. But I didn't make no nose holes. I just had a mouth hole.
Crazy.
And
ass.
I was sucking dick.
She couldn't breathe.
And I almost died.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, like. It wasn't no lift. It was a whole. I looked like I was in the KKK. Like, it was a whole white mask. The only thing that was open was my mouth.
Looking at you.
I passed out and I heard. I actually woke up to somebody dropping my foot. So he was about to move my body. How he was gonna move my body or act like I wasn't doing something? I said, really? I said, really?
You couldn't even dump you.
He couldn't even lift me up from the.
He said, shoulders.
He said, fuck your shoulders, bitch. I have no fingerprints.
I said, what was you doing? I was just trying to wiggle your leg.
No, you wasn't. He was trying to drag you down the stairs.
I don't know what he was gonna do. Mm-mm. And I just passed out because I used to like to get choked. I used to like to get choked like so and like slap. Too. I used to like to have
asphyxiation shit. I just want to learn how to do it better. You know what I'm saying? I want to learn how to do it to the point where I can still breathe, but it doesn't feel like I'm breathing.
Mm-hmm. I think my side hustle, I want to be a dominatrix because I watched this thing called Bundy.
I was thinking about that. I was thinking that, you know what I'm saying, you could actually do that. And, you know, people pay money
for that.
And
so
it's only like 30 minutes, an hour. Because
I already have a whole bunch of.
You know how, how easy it is for us to do that, too. People would love it.
Yeah,
and
women
then sometimes it's not even sexual. It's just like, dominate me. Tell me what to do.
No, they don't have sex. A lot of them don't have sex.
It's the attention thing. Yeah.
I think I could do it.
I'm going to say, the episode she showed me, this man loves to get tickled. Like, that was his thing.
Girl, I be watching some shit on Netflix,
it was
y'all.
One where somebody got asked to get pissed on by another. Yeah.
And I peed on somebody before.
I surely would.
Would you pee on a nigga?
I would.
Shit, if it come with a check.
And I already get paid for, like,
I mean, I pissed on a nigga. It was on accident, but I definitely.
I had two on accident before.
Yeah, I can't be too creepy, though. I had somebody offer me money to piss on them. But he was getting a little too freaky. And I was like, man, the amount that you offering me is not
enough for you to
see my pussy. Yeah. Like, no, it wasn't enough.
If y'all not already fucking.
Yeah.
Probably just get my friend Marcus Nickelberry to come or just probably get a gun or something. Just some backup.
He'll be your backup.
Just wait for that little 911.
I thought you was finna say come and get pissed on. I was finna say, whoa.
Yeah.
Right. You know, he'll come with me. I'm like, girl, boy, I got to do this for some money. He'll be like, oh, okay, Morgan. Mm-hmm. He'll do that mug. And then just go back to work.
For some money. I need to find a website.
Girl, Instagram. Like a website. You already on a website.
Right.
Snapchat. I already
it's
get paid.
It's all in the...
For, like, having people jack off on camera. People give me money for that. Like... So I'll be already on
everything
Snapchat.
Everything is a hustle. Yeah. When I tell you we ain't doing nothing for free, I ain't doing shit.
You can. Can't no woman be broke?
No, not at all.
Can't no woman be broke.
Bro, if you got a pussy, there's no reason why you should be broke. None. Zero. Zilch. Nada.
It's not an option.
As long as you have a vagina, you should never, ever not have money.
Mm-mm.
Because I feel like when you got a pussy, you have too much to offer. You can offer so much with just your pussy and not even having to fuck. Niggas pay strippers thousands of dollars and don't even get to touch them.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, I'm on some money-making shit, so... If I transition just a little bit.
I'm on my cash shit.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? And I turn into a hot girl on y'all ass real quick because.
Real hot girl shit. Shout out to Megan.
I thought I was going to be a city girl this year, but I feel like I'm feeling real hot girlish. You hear me? Because Megan Stallion and came through with a vengeance. That bitch is a beast.
Okay.
Because that cash shit.
H-Time.
Yeah. She from Houston.
Houston.
I can't wait to meet her because I just feel like...
I didn't know she was so tall. I like tall girls.
She's super tall. She's tall like...
She a whole woman. Yeah, she a whole woman.
But she was with my man. And you know what? I didn't even get jealous, y'all.
You talking about money back?
Yeah.
Bitch, me too. I was like, wait a minute.
My nigga, like, if anybody has ever listened to this show, if they follow me on any platforms, they know I am obsessed with money back motherfucking yo.
Yeah.
And... They were together, and all I could think about was...
What they finna come out with.
What they finna come out with, and are they fucking? And then I was like, would you be mad, Solo?
Nah.
Hell nah. That's a fire-ass couple, bro. Them some two bangers.
Yep.
Yeah.
I love to sit in Memphis and Houston. Oh,
I wonder what all type of slang they be saying or they be
fucking. You know what I'm saying?
I used to talk to a Memphis niggas. So, they slang between Memphis, New Orleans, Mobile, and Atlanta. You got to have a different type of mind to understand what the fuck what they saying. Because, baby, I understand everything on an Atlanta nigga saying.
I understand them, but it took me a minute. But you know I was down there for a while. So, yeah, fucking shit.
Uh-huh.
I be like, what the it's fuck like, okay. are you talking about?
And then Mobile, it's like I'm not from Mobile, but my boyfriend, he was from Mobile. It's like a mixture between New Orleans and Atlanta. Bitch.
Oh,
like, you think he'll be talking about something else? Something, and it's totally something different. I used to follow them. Now I know what the fuck they be, how they talk now. Yeah. So I can follow the conversation and whatnot. But, girl, yeah, I wonder what the hell they be saying if they do be fucking. Because I know they be saying some crazy ass shit. Because Houston and Memphis.
I got to hear the, while we fucking, bitch. I don't give a fuck about
give
nothing.
Give me a couple,
if
breath.
I don't get that, I don't want it. And Meg Thee Stallion, she probably telling that nigga, stand up in his pussy.
She probably talking all this shit.
You know what I'm saying? Beat this shit. Ooh. It turns me on to think about it. Moneybag, y'all Meg Thee Stallion, if y'all ever want to get together and have a party, I'm down. I will cross oceans for you.
Take this money. We gonna throw a party on that pussy.
Baby, when I say a fiesta, y'all can get it all.
Yeah.
Both of them. Big old freak and drip too hard. Mr. Bitch, I love him. Mr. Balenciaga. That nigga had Balenciaga on from head to toe. That's my type of hood.
I seen these new Balenciaga shoes, the LED ones.
Mm-hmm.
I just cannot wait till I see somebody up in them hoes.
Changing them lights.
Yes, they are ugly as fuck. They are ugly. And they used to get on the people's ass. You know how them other light up shoes came out? They used to talk about them people. But I know for a fact somebody's going to buy them and they're going to be walking around thinking that
they're fucking Skechers with Balenciaga brand.
That's what they are, Skechers.
It's the S looking ass niggas.
Like, oh my gosh, those are so ugly.
So, okay. If
If y'all can think of a celebrity couple, what celebrity couple would y'all have a threesome with?
I got a few.
Iman Shumpert, definitely agree with you on that one.
I got a few.
I would take both of them down to the ground.
I do.
Even though I think I would get took down because they both look pretty aggressive.
Yeah.
What's yours?
I got Gucci Mane and Keisha Kayor. Mm-hmm. I got 2 Chainz and Keisha. Cause they both ghetto as fuck. They look ghetto. I want to do JCB on say.
Really?
Facts.
You know that yes. Would cut a little snooze fast.
They look like they sex is pretty boring.
I think theirs is like really intense and passionate. I don't even want to do it with them. I just want to look.
Okay.
Like I ain't gotta be involved because I know that's y'all think. Wait, I gotta think about it. I had a list. Okay, y'all can name y'all's. What about you?
A Big Daddy Slim. Slim Thug. Oh, fuck. Anybody with Slim Thug.
She said anybody. Girl, that nigga be in Dallas all the time. We used to catch him at Big T the time.
You know I'm from Houston, so you know that's like, man, say.
I do Kylie and Travis like a motherfucker.
I'd be scared of that sex.
I would do Kylie and Travis.
Mm-hmm. Let me see. So, if they were a couple, I would do Meg Thee Stallion and Moneybagg Yo.
Yeah.
Contrary to the belief, I think I would have so much fun with Tiny and T.I.
They seem like they are loads of fun.
Baby, they seem always like they talking about fucking. Always talking about fucking. And they two little motherfuckers, too. Bitch, give me them two little motherfuckers. Gosh. I'll take them. Let me see who else?
Celeb couple.
I would do Pamela Anderson and Tommy Lee.
Yes.
Are they still together?
They're not together.
Okay. When they was together, I would have been up all up in that thing.
Victoria Beckham and her husband.
Ooh. That's a beautiful sex session. He's so fine. Ooh, I'll do Chris Hemsworth and his wife too. I don't even know what his wife looked like.
Travis Barker and Ashley, his wife. The dude that played, I think it's for Blink 82, played the drums for them.
Mm-hmm.
Or is it Limp Bizkit?
Girl, I don't know.
I forgot. But
I don't know white people culture that much.
Travis Barker. Everybody should know Travis Barker, bro.
Yeah. Like, he had the TV show and he was
Limp. Yeah, I'm saying, so I don't know like the wife. Details. Like, oh, yeah, he was Limp Bizkit.
No, I'm talking about like for people to
recognize him.
He got his own name, Travis Barker.
You know who I wouldn't do?
Who?
Chrissy and John Legend.
Why? I bet it's real kinky.
Because she crazy. Yes,
I do Rihanna and her billionaire boyfriend.
Yeah, I do Rihanna and anybody.
I do
Rihanna by herself. So
I definitely would have did Rihanna and Chris Brown together.
Oh yeah, that's
that's like a perfect. That's like a beautiful nightmare.
Oh, R.I.P., but I would do Nipsey and
No, Lil I would do Drake and Malia.
No, we're not doing that.
I would do Drake and Malia, bro. swear to God. Or Drake and Rihanna.
Current Drake and Anytime Malia.
Yeah, baby. I would do his new girlfriend.
Bitch. Drake, you looking good. Drake looking good
Drake
as hell.
Drake better keep his motherfucking ass off that sideline for somebody else. Drag his ass out of basketball game.
He got a big dick and he got, you know what I'm saying, big dick energy. So you can do whatever the fuck you want to do, Drake.
I mean,
baby, Drake is fine to me now. I love Drake.
I've been in love with him since Aubrey Graham, since Jimmy in the wheelchair. So he was my crush because he was like the only cool black nigga on that show.
I didn't think he was fine until current.
Like a motherfucker.
I think he's definitely champagne poppy now.
Yeah.
But
with that beard, it's the fucking beard, I feel like. And then the fade.
And the muscles.
Oh, Lord Jesus. The fade, the beard.
The game.
Drake, you just looking good, chap.
Well, y'all, we didn't run over our time. And this gracious, handsome, good-smelling chocolate man.
Always nicely dressed.
You know what I'm saying? Then gave us a little bit of his time. But we got to get the fuck up out
Pretty
of here.
Pretty teeth.
Thank y'all
for tuning in.
Styles for coming in. It's been another episode of 2BBCs, y'all.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.